Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1493, Variable Charts by Dropdown. Well, hey everyone, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in from Athens, Greece. Mike sent this in, and hey, by the way, it's a holiday week here. I know that podcasts have been sporadic. They're going to continue to be sporadic. I'm heading down to Florida back January 12th, so I'm going to try and get as many done as I can. I kind of go to an every other day. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. But I realize I missed the last 2 days. Just had some client work I had to get done. Mike's question, though. Mike has data. Months, units this year, values this year. Units last year, values this year. And he was looking for some sort of a control, like maybe a combo box or something like that, where he said he could choose where they wanted to show units or sales, and the chart would automatically update to do this. Okay, I said, well, all right, first of all, I'm going to do data validation, Alt-DL, data validation, allow a list, just type units and values in there. That way we can quickly change that cell using the dropdown. And then next, this next trick I've stolen from Mike Alexander of DataPig Technologies. Mike is my co-author on the Pivot Table Data Crunching books. He is a funny guy, and I got this tip from him. And I apologize to Mike. I said, Mike, this is going to solve your problem, but it is just absurdly easy, right? There's no trick at all in this when you see how it's done. So I apologize in advance. This chart here looks like it's getting data from here, but it's not. If we actually look, it's getting its data from columns O and P. Now, what's O and P? Well, that is just an area outside of view, so like out, a couple of screens over outside of the print range where no one's going to see it. Out here in O and P, let me scroll over so you can see it. Well, first of all, I just copy the month names over, so equal A3 and copy that down. And then an if statement. If that H2 with dollar signs is units, then use B3 here. Otherwise, get the values from C3. Similar formula here. If H2 is units, then use D3. That's the values from last year. Otherwise, the sales from last year. So let's see if we can get all this in view at the same time. Take these three columns and make them less wide. All right, so when I choose units here, you said these formulas update for units. And then it was just a simple matter of creating the chart based on that data. Insert chart, and so on. That kind of all makes sense. To get the units and values, that's actually a text box. I put the text box in there, insert, shapes, text box, and then in the formula bar, typed an equal sign and clicked on cell H2 to get that formula, so that way it updates as well. So a very nice, cool trick that Mike Alexander showed me that makes people think that we're variably getting the data from here in the chart, but in reality, we're using this helper range out to the right-hand side to solve the problem. Well, hey, I want to thank Mike and Reese for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.